Radiant team ban.
I should have seen that one coming.
Dire team pick. Radiant team pick.
Tiny.
Dire team pick. Seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team pick.
Welcome back. Quickly getting through the games in the series here in the Dota Pit Season 4 NA, or America's qualifiers, I should say, since we do have some South American teams doing pretty well in this little group stage. But the final series of tonight, NME GG against EWolves. We're already seeing NME GG with the startings of the draft we've seen before. Invoker Abaddon, and I'm feeling a Terrorblade coming. My co-caster Fandango. What do you feel about this NME GG lineup?
Five
and BSJ.
Remaining.
Like in general, or just the heroes they have right now?
In general.
Time.
We'll start with that.
Pretty surprised with how well they've been doing, to be honest. Like, they're outperforming my expectations, I guess you'd say. So, good. I mean, there are a few players on
Dire
it that definitely are like pretty high up there in the NA Dota ladder, so they are obviously good players, just can they gel the team? And so far they've been doing okay. I wouldn't say that they, you know, they're blown like my mind or anything, but they definitely put on some nice performances. So I think that Invoker's definitely been their like go-to hero, right?
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, that's what I thought.
They've gone for like Five Invoker, tried remaining. To get Abaddon, and then they have these kind of pre-made strats where BSJ gets Terrorblade, Ursa, Slark, or wait, there's one more. Terrorblade, Slark, Ursa, Phantom Lancer. I think the makings of this, we saw this from EG, I think at the summit, where they had Invoker, Abad, and Lone Druid, and they did the Alacrity Shield and just sent them there forward, and he crushed buildings and crushed everyone. They also like having the Ogre. Like, Ogre, Abad, and dual offlane for EnemyGG has worked out pretty nicely. They just like these steroid heroes that pump up BSJ's hero and allow him to, like, 1v5. We'll see how their draft progresses. Elite Wolves right now, Bane Tiny combination, Nightmare into Toss. Been pretty popular the past month or so. The Zeus, though, hasn't been a go-to hero for many people, especially not in the second pick phase. What's the idea behind that?
It's hard to tell right now. He's good at dealing with teams that want to group up. Like, he pumps out a lot of AoE magic damage with the static, whatever, I can't think what it's called, attack charge, I think. And he's just able, and like Arc Lightning, he's able to make it so Abaddon has trouble keeping everyone's HP topped off. I mean, and also you're able to like kind of take everyone down at the same time, which Abaddon doesn't deal with. Like, he's good at dealing with, you know, keeping one hero alive at a time. So, and himself. It's okay. I don't necessarily know if that's best pick in that scenario, but we'll see if they have some other like heroes that they plan to pick to back him up. Maybe they just wanted to see the new cosmetic. I don't know.
The Arcana there. The rework.
Yeah. They better have the Arcana at least. I've seen people picking Zeus that. I mean, come on. It's only, what, $40? I don't even know how much it costs.
It's insane. It's insane. It's like
pretty expensive.
30-something euros? It's crazy. But do have Van playing for them again. The last time we saw them, Doomsday was still standing in for Van. But now, who's missing? Soku? Soku's missing.
Yep.
Doomsday, he was playing offlane, but I'm still yet to see where this is going to match up, because Van was always that guy that liked his 1v1s, he liked playing in the offlane, but could also switch to safe lane. Ewo, Mash, we'll see how they actually pair up. But EnemyGG, there's the BSJ Ursa, left through the banning phase and allowed to get picked up there. Safe lane role. Elite Wolves, they've got decent ways of dealing with him. They've got Bane to kite him a little bit with Nightmare Fiend's Grip, Tiny to toss him back. A little bit more control here, because they still have to deal with heroes like Abaddon and Witch Doctor. Can't stun you up and that control coming out of the Bane. Final ban. Good support here. The final hero. Vengeful Spirit to take out. We've seen a lot of Loom done Witch Doctor and Venge, so it's kind of interesting that they do ban the Venge. You could feel that it's going to be a frozen hero that comes out next, and he's lovely Ogre recently, honestly, playing a ton of Ogre.
Yeah, in general, remaining. I don't know, Witch Doctor Venge does not seem like a very strong support duo, even if it wasn't those players. Remaining. It's kind of... really don't have great synergies together, or even with any of the heroes on the team, so... Radiant Ogre would be a pretty good pickup for them. The AA pick, I think, is very nice. It makes the Zeus way stronger. It makes their whole draft make more sense. They're very easy, or easily able to burst down heroes, which is an AA blast, plus like Zeus combo, plus any amount of burst, like they got Bane, Brainsap, they've got Tiny combo, so they have no shortage of damage. Their biggest weakness right now, I would say, probably their lanes. 10 seconds. So they just want to make secure their lanes, make sure they have good lanes. I'm not 100% certain where all these heroes are going. Phantom Assassin is their last pickup. It's kind of interesting. Oh, I think it might be offlane Zeus. I'm pretty sure that the Peruvian teams in general, like South American teams even, they all like to play offlane Zeus.
Van used to play a ton of it. Like, his three heroes when it comes to mind were Batrider, Slark, and Zeus.
So I guess the AA Phantom Assassin, a great landing combo, especially since the dagger applies the... whatever the thing is.
Chilling touch.
Yeah. All the spell names, like, skip my mind. I have, like, different names for them, so I have to, like, try and remember what the spell's actually called. Just, like, I always call that one Cold Hands for some reason, even though it's the wrong one.
Icy Hands!
Yeah, yep. I don't know. But, like, yeah, so that's a pretty good combo, and plus the Stifling Dagger into the Cold Feet, like, is pretty good for setting up the stun. And it's also just, in general, a good hero against Ursa. Like, all those heroes have a lot of right-click physical damage. That's where a majority of their damage comes from, so he is good against that. Good pickup. That pretty much solidifies the offlane Zeus, and then they'll probably have Tiny mid. They could potentially do Tiny Bane bottom and a PA a mid, but I don't think we'll see that. Now, I'm interested to see what EnemyGG picks up here. What do you think?
I kind of like Disruptor here. I like Displacement against heroes that want to jump forward and initiate and then maybe, you know, run themselves back. Damage from range, you know, Zeus, PA, and Tiny. Also against the Bane, cancel out the Fiend's Grip with Glimpse, Static Storm, like that. It gives Ursa a much easier time jumping on a target, but...
Oh, it's the, right back to the Ogre.
it's the initial thing we were talking about. Frozen has played a lot of Ogre recently, and it's going to be the dual lane. Abaddon Ogre is just...
It is a good lane.
It's insanely difficult to handle. 8 armor on Ogre, 700 and whatever HP, basically 900 effective HP at level 1, whatever crazy amount it is. Really, really tough to handle. Plus the HP regen he has, which I forget the value, but it's like 3
HP. It's like 3.5 or something like that.
Add in a couple of mangoes and he's up to 5.
He's a good hero. His weakness is really he doesn't have a lot of lane sustain for mana. So it's like you're kind of like just a fat dude that walks around and hits people. It's good if you don't get kited or if you can have other people to back you up and you just kind of, you know, run at them maybe with a Orb of Venom and start the fights. But you can kind of struggle in that, in like long drawn out laning stage, which I think is what they're going to end up having. I think if they do the lanes that we are believing they're going to do, which is Abaddon, Ogre, bottom, Ursa, Wishdoctor, top, and then mid Invoker, EWolves will probably respond with something like Zeus offlane, which I think does pretty well against the Ursa Witchdoctor lane, because he can just kind of get CS with the lightning, try and avoid the Witchdoctor, and harass the Witchdoctor pretty hard if the Witchdoctor doesn't have a stick, which I doubt he will have it very early. And he'll just get like decent CS and won't get completely shut down. Mid will be Tiny versus Invoker, which I guess I think if it was old Invoker, like before the nerf with the Alacrity, Invoker would destroy him. Like it wouldn't even be close because he gets like 30 damage, or he used to get 30 damage with level 1 Alacrity. So you just go Alacrity and out CS him and harass him. But I think with the new change, it should be pretty even. But I think the bot lane, like that will be where all the action will be. And I really do believe EWolves will like... I think Bane PAA is a pretty strong tri lane that two melee heroes will have a lot of trouble dealing with. And A has always been a pretty good hero to... at all stages of the game against Abaddon. Abaddon struggles with that hero pretty hard.
Now, during that pause, I'm sitting here thinking, I wanted to make a bet with you how many mangoes were going to get purchased this game. Because, no, I'm not kidding. Lumdun, I've seen him play Venge and Witchdoctor Bunch, and he almost always goes double mango with tangos that he, you know, pulls to his mid player. In this game, there's one mango on Lumdun, one mango on Sovereign, one mango on Frozen. And that's what I would have said. I would have said 3 mangoes for NME. But, I mean, Smash!
Yeah, he kind of threw the odds out the window there, huh?
Smash on the Zeus has 5 mangoes. Ah, okay.
Heck, this is one of the most advanced maneuvers I've seen someone pull out in the beginning of the game so far. They 5-man checked the Roche Pit and then smoked out of it and are going to contest the top rune. I mean, if they get a rune in the first spot off of the smoke, it's probably worth it, to be honest. Like, it's a pretty decent play. Okay, now they're just, like, using it to scout and trying to follow them. They're trying to take a level 1 fight. This is pretty interesting. I like this play a lot. The question is, will they get a kill out of it? If they get a kill, it'll be worth it.
Yeah, they will. Frozen was so close to scouting that with the Observer Ward. Slayer walks forward. They've got the blink forward, the strike in from Ewo. And Slayer's dropping low. Chilling Touch is there, but the slowdown by the Ignite. Slayer wants to try and deny himself the Roshan, but he's not going to be able to. As the Phantom Assassin gets kill. Bounty runes, bounty runes, bounty runes. Invoker
yeah,
did
split
get
it. Actually. Yeah, so that was like, actually, it was still good. I think it was still probably worth the smoke, but if they got double bounty rune and the first blood there, which I think they could have. I don't know why Van didn't skill up stun. Like, if he skill up stun, he could have stunned Invoker and gotten it. I'm like 90% sure.
It's for this man. The Nightmare into toss
that
back.
Is, all right, all right.
Tier 1 tower. Slayer has just got himself back space, back to tier 1 mid, and now he's already dropping incredibly low. Hit level 2, so he does have that Wex up, but oh my goodness. Bottom lane, what's happening down here? The shield is up on the Ogre, charging forward onto the PA. The blink first, so there is no blur, no dagger. Frozen, the tanky guy. Yeah, 636 HP, not 730, which I thought it was, but 8 armor. Magic damage from AA can rip through the HP pretty nicely, doesn't care about armor at all. The smash offlane Zeus. So Van is on the Tiny. Let's go over on. on that Bane. Mango OP. 6 HP regen a second on the Zeus. Yeah, it's a little bit insane.
I didn't quite expect that build. It's pretty interesting, but the problem is now he's at like 100 HP and he can't really
do anything. He needs, I don't know. I don't know if I, I mean, I like it, but it's definitely, you need some more regen. I think even going like 2 mangoes would have been fine, or 3 even wouldn't have been horrible, but 5 mangoes, you need the salve so you can like trade if you get caught out and salve up and come back to lane, stuff like that. But it's always fun to see the crazy builds. And then I guess like you said, the in the drafting stage, the tiny Bane mid combo is very strong. We'll see if they're able to get the Invoker with it, because I think their bottom lane is going to suffer a lot for this, though. Like, the Ogre Abaddon will win the dual lane. I think with the tri-lane, they could have been... It would have been a very difficult lane for them. Because Abaddon's the type of hero that really needs to, like, snowball in lane, and if he gets shut down early, he is a pretty weak hero.
Eternal Envy's been spamming PA recently.
I know, I've seen...
Not been doing so well with the hero. Interesting, yep. To watch, but... Poor man shields, Phantom Assassin. Now, where do you think PA actually fits in? Because I know I've had this discussion with Cap and Blitz a fair amount, and even though, you know, her skill set screams kind of game-ish carry with the fact you've got crit and evasion built into your hero, stat gain is not amazing, you know, strength gain is pretty low, agi's decent, you know, pretty high, but I don't know, overall I think it's more of a mid-game focused hero where you just like spam stats and try and run at people. Supports are.
Personally, I don't think the hero is even very good, like, at all, but I do think that in this particular game, he's going to try and build more towards the late game. It can kind of do both, I guess. If you do build for late game items, like, you can go later, but if you go, like, the earlier, like, SNY and stuff like that, you can fight earlier. I think he'll just go Basher, BKB, probably, and he's kind of, like... almost a setup for them if he does that with his like random procs on Stifling Dagger. If he crits someone or stuns someone, then they just Zeus ult or like Zeus nuke them and AA blast them, they'll die most of the time. So I guess that's kind of where the hero fits into this particular lineup. He doesn't really need to be going into the like front lines. He should just be sitting back throwing daggers. Tiny can initiate. I'm assuming that Tiny's going to go Blink Dagger, like the kind of ganking Tiny build. He'll be setting up for the kills.
Yeah, I reckon so as well. So looking at this Ursa, you need mobility against this guy. BSJ, his builds have kind of varied. We've seen him, the majority of the time, he kind of goes to phase, Morbid Mask, takes Roshan, gets a Blagger. But there's also been the build where he goes Brown Boots into Idas, then goes into like BOTs, Helm of the Dominator. He goes a little more late game focused and really secures that farm. Because Ursa is a hero that cannot flash farm, relies quite heavily on kills in the mid game especially to keep gold income flowing. BSJ sort of, you know, halts a little bit. Because he needs. What's something good about that Midas build to actually fall back on?
Getting a lot of pauses today.
So,
yeah.
Do you know if Lundan actually... He's tagged up, so it looks like he's actually joined the team now. Because he was a standard.
As far as I know, yeah, he was always on the team. He just didn't have, like, the tag up. Probably couldn't change it or whatever. But yeah. He has to change his internet connection. How much time? What? How do you even change your internet connection? Like, I'm assuming by that he means, like, is he running to another house or something? Like, plugging the ethernet cable into a different wall? I don't understand.
I don't know. There's a lot of streamers and people who get hit by DDoS in seven minutes. I like that exact number, 7 minutes. No, there's a lot of streamers. I know Wagamama in particular. They run 2 or 3 internet connections, and they pay for multiple connections just in case one gets DDoSed or has issues. They always have a fallback. I don't know if that's the case here for this player, but yeah, mainly it's like a business thing where you have like a fallback internet connection, or at least you have like a 4G connection to go back.
I really doubt he's in that situation. Yeah. Maybe they are, though. I think they might. Actually, I don't know if they're playing at like a team house. I'm not 100% certain. If they were, it would probably be happening in the mall, right? So, probably not. Kind of weird. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's, like, illegal, or, like, at least against the terms of service of my internet provider for me to have more than one internet connection. Like, if
really?
I did it, yeah, I'm pretty sure. There's...
Land
internet
of the free?
It's not a fun place to go for internet, trust me. It's the worst in the world, I'm sure. Like, there's so many monopolies and just, like, competition. Well, I guess not competition, but just, like... They are just so deeply rooted that
Comcast.
It's hard to do anything.
AOL.
Comcast is the internet that I have. So yeah, that's one of them. Time Warner, stuff like that. Now they're all combining into one. Good times.
So now you're just waiting for Google Fiber to roll in, huh?
Unfortunately, it's going to be a long time. Actually, I live in Washington, and they had like one of the first fiber connections that were like, but it's more in Seattle area, and it's like they tried to turn it into a utility, which, dear Lord, that would have been the greatest day ever. But unfortunately, I don't think that happened. I stopped following it. Look, actually, Congress has not been that bad for me lately, I'm not gonna lie. Like, I've learned to survive with it. It's fine. I haven't had any, like, major issues in the past, like, 6 months.
Yeah, I'm ruining your life.
Not recently. There's been periods of time, though, where it's just like, this can't be a service I'm paying for.
How is this happening to me? Do they still have, like, little caps on data you can use over there?
Depends. I do not, really. That's one of the nice things. That's why I probably don't hate Comcast as much as some people, but there's plenty of places that do.
That's something that's been zoned out completely in Europe.
Yes, that's nice.
there's almost no providers now that are like, oh, by the way, you can only download 100 gigabytes a month. Have fun with that.
It's mostly phased out, I believe, but there's certainly places that still do it. Especially in, like, rural areas, I think, that just have, like, horrible infrastructure still. So they need, to like, ways to limit people from just using the entire line, basically. It's just like, if you're on, like, doing this all the time, then no one else will use the internet. That's how bad it is in some places, so.
Yeah. I was super happy when I moved away from England to Berlin. Because in the UK, where we first lived, we had, I don't know, like, 13 minute download and, I don't know, 2 up or something, and that was... Oh, it was as good as you could get in the area. And this was North London. Like, this is near the capital city, where internet actual infrastructure was still running on the stuff from the 60s, those copper wires. It was too expensive to rip up the roads, to actually install fiber and stuff like that. They're slowly rolling it out. Moving to Berlin, oh my goodness, like, everywhere. No matter where you go, it's like 100 over 100. There you go, have internet. Easy stuff. But then you compare it to Eastern Europe, Sweden, Norway, Latvia, Lithuania, places like that. Even go across to, like, Southeast Asia, like Singapore and stuff. 100-100 is basic amenity kind of thing. Like, you get that stuff in schools and universities.
Yeah, for free. Mm-hmm. It's a different thing.
Yeah, it's rejoined, hasn't it?
As far as I can tell.
I want to see these mangoes in action. Still wondering how Zeus actually fares up against the Witch Doctor trading hits?
Not with 5 mangoes, not well, because the Witch Doctor still has a Fairy Fire and 2 Tangos, so he's doing pretty good on the HP regen department. Plus, if he gets level 2, he'll have his food restoration, which he can just use to zone the Zeus. I mean, Smash got the top rune, so he actually has gotten no experience so far. I mean, there's only been 1 creep, but he's been zoned out of that, and I just don't see how he's going to get back into range to really pick up that experience at this point. I think he needs to ferry himself a salve, pretty much.
Not like he can pull this camp across either, or even farm the camp to the east. Large camp's pretty much off bounds for him.
Yeah, he could stack and farm it with Arc Lightning, but it would be, you know, not for a while, so he can't do it, like, right away. He needs static field, at least.
10 years with a cloak aura on the little potato,
yeah.
The hell bear.
Yeah. It's gonna take forever. If you get those, it would take forever. I don't know, he's kind of in a rough spot. Maybe the Bane could rotate up somehow and, like, try and pressure him, like, the Witch Doctor off so that Zeus could get a level or two so that he could then be more competitive against the Witch Doctor, but I think he's pretty content with sitting mid and having Tiny toss people at him. So, we'll see how that goes. I just looked at the Banesville, actually. He's got a Null Talisman and pooled Tangos? Somebody pooled Bane Tangos? That is the greediest support I've ever seen. Who did that? That was I don't even know who it was. It looks like it might have been AA, based on the items that most people have.
Oh, heck. Tiny has a pooled Tango. Wait, hang on. So Bane has pooled Tiny Tangos. Also,
oh,
Bane,
yeah,
pooled himself.
It looks like he probably pulled Tiny one too many and then just took one back. I guess he probably pulled them a bunch and then took them back. I can't even tell.
Bane has pulled Tiny 2 Tangos, because one of the shared Tangos is on cooldown, so Van had 2.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
That means Bane was given 2 Tangos by the AA.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just pulling Tangos around.
Yeah, just sharing the love. Give everyone a bit of Tango.
Putting them on cooldown. Making it harder to use, taking up your inventory. It's fine, though. He'll probably use one of them here pretty soon. He might even give one of the shared Tangos back to Tiny.
Player on this mid-info.
2 minutes. Do Do we get an ultimatum that something that happens when
I'm pretty sure it's just like resume the game or forfeit on a deal. Yeah. Oh, go, good timing.
He's back.
Timing. We had a situation last night. I think it was EWolves. I can't remember. It's been a long week of spamming NA games for me, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Where one team literally had 30 seconds to join the lobby. They were missing a player. They had like 30 seconds to join the lobby. He joins in straight into it. So long. I think Complexity were playing up against them, and they were, you know, when do we get the default win? No, Complexity are very good with that. They're very forward in asking, when do we get this? when do we get
I
this
mean,
win?
Hey,
we're getting tired of waiting.
It's kind of annoying when you're expected to play at a certain time and people just don't show up. But then again, it's just different scenarios for different people, especially if you're a team that's like a professional team dealing with more of like a semi-professional amateur team. It's harder to expect punctuality out of them when they're have other things going on, but still, it's like if you schedule for it, you should be there.
Wait, miss coming.
Mm-hmm.
All right, here we go. We've had our break. 25 minutes of waiting, and we finally
get
back.
Analyze
underway.
The starting item builds pretty deeply. The mangoes.
We didn't even talk about the Abaddon. Doesn't really matter. He's got a mango and a shield. All the venom on
his
the
build's too normal. Fine. That's boring. Just look at the mangoes.
We just looked at the Zeus for 20 minutes. That's more than enough. There's still lane now up in the face. The chilling touch is out. More of a deterrent than anything, I think, just to try and force Sovereign and Frozen back a little bit. Slayer mid. He just used his salve and he's already dropped down to half HP again. 1 point up in the quas. I give him a good amount of regen, but I don't know if it's enough because look at Van. He's just waiting for that mana to come back up. Takes a bit of harass out here from Slayer's Invoker with a cold snap through. Just that. In fact, he doesn't have a clarity though on this Tiny. Waiting for that bottle to come in, I guess, but there's no Nightmare Toss available just yet. You really want to go on this Invoker, right? Bottle's coming out now. It's just a matter of time until this Invoker dies.
He just needed that bottle. He was being so greedy for that last CS. He had 600 gold, and he's just like, he lost half of a salve just because he wanted to try and get it. Now he's going to have to sit and wait. The bottle's coming out. He'll get the rune probably as well. Looks like Smash is going
to
come middle.
Bounty rune for him?
I don't know, maybe. Yeah, like, okay. Maybe the bounty rune. Bane's coming in with the sleep. Not going to get it. Still doesn't have the bottle on Tiny anyways, so it wouldn't have mattered. Plus, the creeps are pushed up too far now for them to do like the toss back combo, right? They can still just wombo combo, and I think it would still be a kill with Brain Sap plus the... Maybe they need level 3. It'd be close, because he has the Fairy Fire and the Boots now as well.
Well, but Zop Smash has finally hit level 2. Healed, and Lundin actually goes for the Maledict. So stun Maledict, and I guess with the damage output from the Ursa. I always get a little bit surprised at how short the cooldown is on Earthshock, 5 seconds and the 75 mana cost. It's really quite easy to spam it out, and we're all... Right.
I believe he's dead.
I believe he's also dead. I mean, the cast won't bounce back, but there's phase boots on...
Phase boots, no boots on Smash. So he's definitely going to catch up to him. He'll just Earthshock, slap him with Maledict, and... Yeah, Smash has accepted his fate. He's also analyzed the situation and realized the error of his ways. So best thing he can do in this situation is buy his items. He might be able to get a TB scroll and boots, which I don't know if he wants to sacrifice a whole mango in his inventory for those two items, but we'll see.
Okay, Smash.
I think he'll be able to get both.
Your fate determined. BSJ, yep, in we go. Maledict is there. The Furious
Flux. TB scroll and boots. He's dead.
He gets the items bought. I mean, did he lose any gold there?
No. It was actually not that bad for him. The fact that he got those items bought was pretty significant, because he needs the boots to have any chance to kite a phase boots Ursa, or else he's just going to die every time he gets... With boots, as long as he doesn't get too out of position, maybe he can take some winning experience.
Leia somehow got out of that situation pretty nicely. The Nightmare down, but Tornado just before the toss came through. Looking to survive the pull across. Bottom lane. And then Frozen farming up with the Radiant Creep Wave helping them take the large camp. Drag it back into the wave as well, but it is a double wave with a catapult here from the Radiant. I don't know how much damage they can do to this tier 1 in bottom lane, or if they actually want to press any further forward. Just smash! Come down to join them, the blink forward onto Frozen with a Chilling Touch damage. Aphotic Shield is there onto that Ogre though. They'll take him down. The damage output is good enough. Meanwhile, the mid. What's he doing?
Not gonna lie, I missed that one as well. I think that he was just Maybe he rotated in and woke up, then Voker. I actually didn't see any of what happened, but let's see if he has a TP scroll. If he buys one here, we might be able to see if he's on cooldown. No, he bought a ward. I think he might have TP'd into mid, died waking up to Invoker, because he was asleep.
Oh man, plus him onto Smash. Now all the Ghost Walk reveal him for a little bit, but Slayer has been pretty on point with these timings. Tornado and Ghost Walk, both well done. The Witch Doctor was actually over towards the Ancient Ramp of the Radiant.
Oh, so he just got caught like walking over trying to gank her ward or something?
Yeah, looks like it.
Well, this mid lane is like really low CSing lane. I mean, both of the players. The Invoker is super behind because they've all just been so focused on killing and surviving as opposed to getting the CS. I don't really know. I suppose that probably favors the Tiny, especially since he's just so ahead, but... Where's receiving back to mid?
But then there's BSJ up at top, 34 last hits, doubling up on the PA. So the safe lane PA has been all but shut down by the Ogre of Adden lane. Even if they give up kills, still fine. Ewo just being shoved, look at him! Shoved off the creep wave, now they're chasing down with the Doomsday, the Ancient Apparition. Blowed down with a shield onto Sovereign now, he counts out the slow and the stun is there from Frozen. Even pops the fairy fire, but it's just delaying the inevitable. That's now the one taking the full brunt of the action.
Yep. Now that the Abaddon has picked up his phase boots, this lane is going to be very difficult for them. And this is why I was saying, like, I really don't think that the value for EWolves came out of that dual lane mid. Like, they really didn't get any kills, right? So, and if you're not getting kills, then he's basically just stealing his Tiny's experience and didn't harass the Invoker too much. I mean, to be fair, they did stop, like, Invoker from CSing a decent amount, but I think if they had just tri-lane bottom with the AA Bane PA, they could have just killed the... At least for the first, like, maybe minute or two, and then the Bane can just roam mid and get an easy sleep on Invoker. Here comes the toss. Yeah.
There's the tower. Invoke is off cooldown, the damage output is just about there, though, under the tower, and bam, still at the avalanche to throw.
See, I mean, that combo is still really strong, but it's like, trying to do it at level 1 is pretty optimistic, to say the least, I think. Because the guy has to be pretty out of position and be super far forward if you're going to get a toss far back enough that's actually going to kill him. So I think it's more of a thing that you try and rotate in and do, instead of just static the lane and do it.
Do EWolves have any way of moving to top to kill BSJ?
At this point, it's pretty hard. He's got a stick, his phase boots, lifesteal, so he's like always going to be pretty full on HP. I don't see the potential in there. It would require Tiny, for sure. They would have to have Tiny rotate up there, and they'd have to, like, combo him before he gets his ult off. It's borderline impossible, unless they catch him in, like, a spot where he doesn't see them, and they see him. Looks like they're gonna try and catch... This is a good kill if they kill him before he hits 6. Very good rotation.
Abaddon, yep. Straight onto Abaddon Sovereign. Like you said, not level 6 yet, and they're actually gonna go for more here. It's Frozen, Avalanche, toss back onto Ewo, and Musco is here. The nightmare, if they really need it. Go down Frozen's retreat, but it's a toss from Van which will secure kill. 2. EWolves. Laning phase has gone decently for them kill wise. But how are we looking actually, like, overall net worth wise? Enemy are leading by about 1,000.
Yeah, that rotation really salvaged them, because they were pretty behind before that, but now it's pretty much pretty even. Canron really came in the clutch there for Tiny, got him the extra kill. Cooldown reduction was pretty big. They're actually gonna try and kill him again. They got the sleep, he's still on 6. TP coming in from Ogre though, they're gonna toss him back. This is really greedy, no mana on the Tiny.
Another shield and Van, oh, he's not gonna die just yet. Sovereign chasing, he's hunting with the movement speed he's got, not gonna catch up in time. The EMP might slow down that defeat though. Meshko, the Bane Elemental, cannot nightmare himself. He's just gonna get right clicked down and pounded by Slayer and Frozen until the crits from Ewo come out. Forward, but the tornado, fairy fire, 5 stick charges as well. It's down to this evasion, down to the misses. The stick charges bait Ewo in, but it's also a reverse bait as the Ghost Walk. Book comes back off cooldown and Slayer slowing down the Phantom Assassin, has to try and blink across the creeps, but it's all over for him.
I think that kill attempt was pretty optimistic from Ewo. He even got super lucky. He got like the double crit. Like, that's pretty nice, but trying to dive onto that Invoker, didn't really have a well thought out way to kill him besides I'm going to run into this guy and crit him until he's dead. It was pretty close though, both of them baited with the 6. I think they would have been really happy with that trade though if they didn't take the extra dive.
They did lose the PA, I think it's all fine. But BSJ has moved off top lane, this is relatively obvious. He has shoved top, so it, you know, it looks like he might have dipped back into the jungle. As soon as these two creep waves meet, EWolves should realize, unless they're too preoccupied mid, as the tornado comes into the EMP and Tiny's caught, the stun bounce back onto Van. Mash? Turn and try and bait this one out? Nope. Just get the Tiny out of there. Make sure he survives, and now the pings come out. Feel like it's a little bit too late. BSJ has already shredded his way through Roshan. They see him with that ice vortex, but it's dead. That was really well timed. Oh, can they get the PA here? No stuns and she blinked back.
I feel like all out of mana, it looks like just about. Oh, Invoker's actually coming in. He's got tornado EMP. No other spells though. Has fallen. Just annoying that. Yeah. Sending him back to base.
Back to base you go. And they've got arcanes on the ogre now, so they could potentially look to take down this tier 1. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Right, Helm of the Dominator for BSJ.
There we go. It's pretty close to Blink Dagger. Yeah. Enemy is hitting that point where they have really strong group up heroes. The Abaddon is 6, they have arcanes on Ogre to give him some mana. I'm assuming this Invoker is getting his urn, which he's pretty close to. And BSJ is pretty close to Blink, and they're just gonna run at them. And you don't really have good heroes or tower sieging, so the Zeus, if he's really careful about positioning, he can probably protect against like tier 2 pushes pretty easily, and even tier 1s if he's preemptively set up. BSJ is actually just running at top by himself. Should be Aegis dead for sure. And a very good back from EWolves. A lot of teams, or a lot of players especially, would try and stay in that situation and try and get the second kill, but they would have gotten wiped. So they back off, take the Aegis, and now they can just like rotate Zeus to top. He can defend against this 5-man push, and they can just push out the other lanes.
The Phantom Assassin some time to farm at bot. It's just a lonely ogre down here for now.
They really need that 6 on AA too. That's like, this is good that he's going to mid to farm. He needs to try and get this. It's almost more important that he gets farm right now than the Phantom Assassin. Because once they get 6, they can take team fights on the AA.
We're not seeing the blink on Tiny. Going for the phase drums. Gonna get hit by the tornado. With the EMP there, BSJ jumps forward and Van, you are dead, my friend. Smash, maybe the second one to fall. They don't really have another way to catch up. Top of that target. Like, Mr. Vayne is ready and waiting in the wings. PA in here, actually. BSJ, oh, blink cancelled by the Arc Lightning there. Tier 1 tower is dropping relatively quickly, and I don't think EWolves have... It doesn't feel like they've got any good way of fighting into this, but is it just the Zeus spamming out that's stopping enemy from going
in? Pretty much. That's what they should have had like happen right there, is the Bane should have just sat behind the Zeus top. If the Ursa goes on him, he just sleeps him. Preferably, you obviously don't get jumped on, right? Like, the Zeus just gets Arc Lightnings off and keeps the Blinks on cooldown. And he just keeps pushing it out, and then the other people push the other lanes. But they just kind of grouped everyone up, they got jumped on because they got out of position, and... It almost opened up the tower to death, but their heroes are just so weak at killing towers that they still weren't able to finish it off. They're coming back, actually. And they do have ward vision that, like, there's not a lot of heroes in this general area, so they know this is pretty safe.
Is ready, BSJ pops his ulti, Brain Sap is there, and the cask actually bounced back onto the Bane.
I'm kind of surprised they didn't open up with a grip there. Because even though there's a Witch Doctor standing there, I think if they grip him and BSJ doesn't get his ult off and they just go like all in on him, they might burst him down there. Kind of risky play though. Don't see why they wouldn't do it.
Now Sovereign's down at bot. Stop this Ancient Apparition getting level 6, but it's going to happen eventually. He'll get there. Frozen, level 8 on this Ogre. Now we were speaking about the strengths and weaknesses of Ogre. Like, if you're ahead, you can charge at targets, you get into these sort of skirmishes where you basically bully people out of lane and you bully people out of fights. Great for the Ogre. EWolves ever get into a position where they have the strength and power to push into tier 1s, Ogre can't really clear waves, he can't initiate and start into a fight too well, he just wanders in and casts his spells out. Really get some good items, you know, mobility items like War Staff, Glimmer Cape, stuff like that. I think that's something they have to look for. Obviously, there's Witch Doctor who would love to have an Aghanim Scepter. AA. Pretty sure you are an... Oh, no, you can just TP. You can just TP. Never mind. No stuns for Abaddon.
Yeah, that's the one thing he's got going for him. He's trying to just hide, but half of his time he's not even CSing. He's just sitting in experience range, trying to 6, which is what he should do. Zeus ult comes out to scout Limden, who's behind in the trees.
The stun Maladex is there. Loomfen is healing himself up and with a tornado through the shield onto the Witch Doctor. Phantom Assassin, oh man, tries to TP, but there's no escape, no retreat from NME. Ballsy play.
Gold and sweet.
It's only a Witch Doctor as well. I could understand if they were potentially getting a kill on anyone else.
Yeah, that was kind of greedy. I mean, I think they should have expected the TP rotations. So now that they got this kill, they're trying to turn it into a push. I think the Zeus Bane should be able to hold this, especially with Ursa killing a bot, who does have 6 finally. Is he going to be able to kite him? Oh my gosh, he's going to live. That was so close.
PSJ turned.
Yeah, I think he could have gotten there.
A was here, he blinked forward.
To be fair, he did not know where very many people were. It's been really dark on the map for a while, and if he chased there and got Fiend's Grip and like someone TP'd, he probably dies.
And I see them up the top now, the Bane. Nightmare to run the hell away. Smash just has to continue spamming out. With the Ice Blast coming across, not going to clip anybody. Where is this Tiny? So his drums are up, he's got the DD rune bottled as well. Still think he goes back for a Blink Dagger, or is it at this point you think into that big old carry Tiny?
That's actually kind of tough. I think with the AA, you need the blink. Like, they need some way to initiate and burst someone in the fight, right? And if they have the AA ult, if he even hits one important hero, or maybe two less important heroes in a fight with the Tiny Wombo combo with the AA Blast plus Zeus ult, they're gonna die for a pretty long time. I mean, he's gotta hit Invoker, Witch Doctor, or Ursa, I believe, because the other, I think Ogre and Abaddon are too tanky.
Oh, hang on, BSJ, what are you doing? Trapped in the trees, he misblinked. And that Zeus ulti actually sees him and catches him out. That was super fortunate, because originally EWolves, they thought someone was hiding up on this cliff here. So they ran across, cop on them, then ran sort of towards Ancients and Roche Pit. That one ulti from Zeus to give the scouting intel. They saw BSJ hiding, or stuck, or whatever he was doing.
I didn't catch what he was doing because I was watching the heroes in the middle. I think
he just
farming, yeah, pretty much. Let's see how the item progression coming on Invoker. Working his way towards Orchid. Pretty decent pickoff. The only problem with it is that it doesn't really scale that well against EWolves heroes. Once they start getting BKBs, he won't be able to do anything to them in fights, and they really don't have any good anti-BKB heroes. Best they got is Witch Doctor. Like, Witch Doctor can drop his ward and be like, hey, you guys are BKB'd, run into this. But because he is kind of behind, and he won't have that Ags anytime soon, it's not that threatening.
Thanks to this Phantom Assassin, looks like straight into that BKB rush. A bit worrisome for them if they can't get BSJ onto a target, but that's what he's doing right now. Hunts for the Bane. Nightmare not in time.
I go now to
catch
the
secondary target
to
though. Van is so speedy with Drum's Phase, just sprinting away, galloping the little rock man. He stopped the farmer camp. Tornado, they see him, they know he's here. And loomed over the castle, bounced it back and onto a creep, in fact, but they'll still go onto Van. Not sure if this secures the kill. Death Ward is there. Avalanche to cancel it out, and Van is still running himself away from this. BSJ, blink ready now. Blink, clap, dead, down, no! Toss? He didn't clap. He didn't get the Earthshock there. There's no slow, and Van is being healed up. The bottle keeps him going. That Thunder called Wrath to scout them out and do a bit of deterrent damage. Enemy. Little misplays.
Yeah, Van almost gave him a big kill. That would have been a tier 1 tower basically if Van died there. And now it's not. So pretty significant kill. But he does take out Zeus instantly. Can they kill him here? They do have Fiend's Grip, but he sees them coming in with Observer Wards, so he shouldn't get caught by this. This is a pretty risky dive. TP's come in.
Oh god.
The right thing to do is turn on right away.
Is Bane dead?
This is a good AO though. Oh, they went on different targets.
Jump onto BSJ, but Frozen is killing off the Bane Elemental. Ewo heals himself up through it. BSJ still not dead yet, and the Ice Blast wears off. Meanwhile, on the side, Van kills the Ogre, but that Tornado just dodged one. It was just a little bit short as well from the Slayer. Not long enough, but BSJ, Fiend's Grip up. Don't think the Bane will survive. Ursa somehow gets the final swipe in there. And as we start to look for the next Roshan, a minute and a half until that guy is back up. Up at the top, Van thinking about going to go and steal it or kill off the hero that tries to take it from him. EWolves just getting a little bit too big for their boots. Ice Blast was pretty big, but enemy TP racked perfectly.
Yeah, they're just, a lot of the misplays this game out of EWolves have just been their overcommits at towers. Like, they've been diving for kills that just are way too risky, like that dive on Witch Doctor. Graham's another one, but see, this one's a little better because he sees them all mid and knows that they really don't want to TP and give up that tower to save the Witch Doctor. Pretty decent A blast. Zeus has ult up. They're all TPing in here.
Got shield on BSJ, it's gone now, but the blink forward, Ewo is still hunting down his Ursa. He's got his ultimate up, he needs to pop it now, turn to fight. There's no control except the avalanche, but they've still got shield and heal. BSJ is lasting through it all with the shield back up on him. He just outputs so much damage without being stopped at all. Clap again, but he's finally going to drop to the Phantom Assassin. Right click attack, deafening from Slayer. Sustain from Sovereign, that final miscoil. One hit, slows down Smash, keeps the attack damage coming in from Slayer as well. Not gonna go in too deep though. Voker backs up to go and help his teammate Frozen, who, you know, living up to his name, does get held in place. Doomsday. I mean, goodbye. I must have poor AA. They get the Bane here as well. That's the big question. Slayer, no invoke.
No spells.
No spells.
Well, that was a. Quite the fight. It's all over the place. They really need this BKB up on PA so he can deal more aggressive in these fights without dying every time. Because they do need someone that can dive in, but the Tiny, like, doesn't have the blink, so he can't do it. So the PA has to lead the charge, but he just instantly dies because he's not enough of a threat. Like, Tiny blinking in and one-shotting someone is a pretty big threat. PA blinking in and poking you, hoping to crit with, like, zero damage items, not a really big threat. I really do think this would have been a great game for playing Tiny, but he's gonna have an Ags eventually, and he might even still go blink after Ags, just it might be too late at that point. Picking up the next Roshan, they have the attack speed, so it's really fast on the Ogre.
And they used Ice Blast to scout, so they didn't have it for the team fight if they wanted to go and contest. Yeah. The lens on Ogre. I mean, his cast ranges are, they're pretty awful, to be honest, so.
Yeah, it's a pretty good item on the hero, I like it. Just usually I really don't know why he didn't disassemble his Arcane Boots, because the build-up for this build-up that he's going, it should be Arcane Boots into Aether Lens, into Tranquil's Soul Ring, and then you have like Sustain, and then you go Ags, because when you're using the Ags Ogre, you always zoom anyways, and so the natural build is Soul Ring, Tranquil Boots. But it's still good, because they're like a 5-man lineup, so he's trying to give his teammates mana with the Arcanes, but I don't know.
Oh.
He just died, yeah. At this point, it's like too dangerous for Zeus to protect towers. Now that they're like, it's nighttime, he doesn't have vision of them all. I mean, you have to be like pulling the creeps off before the Ursa's in range to jump on you, and he just wasn't in a position for it early enough.
Here's the 21-minute steroid Ursa coming at you. Shield, Bloodlust, Alacrity crushing through heroes. Alacrity onto the Abaddon for some reason is hit into the tower, I guess is the reason behind that toss. Picks up the shield, cancels the blink of BSJ as well. That was intended, but good play by Van. Stops BSJ initiating onto anyone, but he's got the chance now. He wants to blink forward. They toss the PA into the middle of them all. Gets himself out, but not for too long. The Maldic with the Death Ward. BSJ stunned up, but Ewo, is he going to tick to this? Pops his BKB and he's glimmered up at the last second, yeah. But the Rakts are dying. They're losing their bases. BSJ blinks forward into the Bane. Down he goes and Van. They just need stuns and control for the Tiny. Well, give up the Ogre as a sacrificial lamb here. In the meantime, Slayer has literally not moved from this spot for a good 15 seconds as he just right-clicks down buildings.
That is the name of so many games lost for most teams. Like, the AA, getting Zeus picked off was really, like, was bad. Getting AA pick off was Rax losing, because they really need that AA blast to threaten kills when they're pushing the base. Otherwise, they're never going to burst someone down. And like, even though the Ursa has Aegis, if you can burn his Aegis, it's an AA blast, like, it's better than nothing. And now he still has Aegis, so they can just keep fighting. And, oh no. Oh, did he not see him there? He did. Blinks forward, BSJ. Oh, thinks better of it. But yeah. It's so, like, the range on the Icy Vortex, which is what he was placing down, is gigantic. Now there's no, like, you can stand at the tier 4s and place it on your ramp, so there shouldn't be any excuse to really get caught.
Well, Abaddon, Aghanim's is about 1200 gold away. Not sure if Van can really think about going to kill him. He's 100 gold off his Aghanim Scepter himself. Oh wow, okay. That's something I wasn't really expecting. Ags on Ursa. Sovereign.
That just reduces the cooldown.
You can use the
18 second cooldown, and you can use the little stun. Oh my, that is really strong.
one is using
Sovereign is actually in trouble.
Like mid Fiend's Grip, you're like, yep, what up? Better than, literally better than a BKB.
Wait, does it take off everything? Like, I don't know, how exactly does the purge work for it?
I'm not sure if it takes off, like, Fiend's Grip historically is... can be purged by great, like, there's three different types, like, Dispel and Purge. There's Lesser Purge, Greater Purge, and then there's, like, Dispel. Because you can purge off Fiend's Grip with, like, Legion Commander, whatever.
Yeah, and Abaddon. Those. I don't think that you'd be able to rage out of Fiend's Grip. Because usually it's, like, the Perplex or whatever, right? It's, like, the Sheepstick effect.
Yeah. Because you can't do it with, like, Lotus Orb is a lesser Dispel, a lesser Purge. You can't get rid of Fiend's Grip with that. You can with a Abaddon Shield.
I feel like, oh, he's breaking the smoke right here. Do they have any detection?
Mm-hmm.
One of the problems with so rich is sometimes you get too ahead of yourself and don't buy detection. You're like, I want to buy my item. So all the supports have point boosters instead of detection. Man's going to pick up Lumden right here.
Or is he? Possible. Well, the toss is down. Lumden's still surviving through. The heal comes out. He's dead now to EWolves Blink forward, but BSJ, he's the one that is actually gripped up and going to lose the Aegis on the side. Four heroes surrounding him, but EWolves traps off. Held in place with a big old multicast, and BSG blinks but misses a clap, doesn't catch anybody now, Nightmared up. They'll kite him around a little bit so they get the Witch Doctor. But the damages they took, all their ulties are down, bar Fiend, except the Thunder God's Wrath, but it's a level 9 Zeus. Level 1 ulti, and BSG just moves in, Alacrity. Onto the tier 3.
They can potentially burst in, they have AOL up right now. If they can get a combo on BSG when he goes in right here without him ulting, they ult him, this could potentially kill him. Ooh. Okay, just kidding. The heals.
He's fine.
Yeah. They have to, like, burst him without him getting his auto attacks off. Because if he gets his auto attacks off, like, obviously, which you saw without the AL being up. Oh my lord.
He just jumped straight back in. Good night, yeah. AA. But no BKB on EWO. No ulties available for EWolves. Yes, Jay, he's on the hunt. He just wants to blink onto the target. Where's his blink? Off cooldown now, but they found the Phantom Assassin, but they can blink back a little bit. Van caught by the tornado. Slayer gets them all. I think EWolves. Done for now. Yeah, he can fly back, but Tiny's gone for a good minute. Hang on a second. Force staff back in. Yep, frozen dead in the old fountain.
I mean, they're not going to be able to get the top racks here because the tier 2 is still up, but. Rax is down. BSJ has an Earth, 3200 gold. It's looking pretty difficult for EWolves at this point. Is that A trying to buy Midas when they're this behind? I don't know if I can approve of that.
I kind of dodged that topic because...
Yeah. It's already so grim. I mean, it's like, what does he buy that he can actually get to that's useful at this point? Maybe an Urn, but it's like they're not even really getting that many kills. It's a tough one, to be fair. And if he does get the Midas, it's pretty nice, but they really do need that Ags. It's pretty important this game, and he just got shut down too hard. Mainly because their bot lane didn't go well, because they did try to dual lane and Abaddon dual lane. Like, there's very few dual lanes to feed Abaddon dual lane. There's lots of, like, AA I think is one of the best tri-laners against Abaddon, it's just they didn't actually have a tri-lane, so. The lanes went a little worse than I thought, but I feel like overall they're just, the whole game, they were just kind of getting out farmed and I mean, I haven't watched a ton of NME, to be honest, but just based off of this game alone, and I feel like what you were saying earlier, they really just like to group up. And so if you're diving people under towers and they're a team that like to group up, it's kind of setting them up for success because you dive the tower and they all TP to counter gank, they kill the person that was diving the tower, and then they're all grouped up to push right after it. So kind of setting them up for what they want to do. In general, it's better to just keep the lanes pushed out and then try and avoid their ganks, because they really didn't have a great ganking lineup, right? Like, they have Invoker, so if he gets Ghostwalk Tornado, that might work, and Banana Slide Jamma with the Blink could maybe catch someone, but other than that, looks like they're still making a last stand, though. I think that trying to make it at the tier 2 is a little ballsy, but here comes the Tornado MP, completely whiffs.
Bat is stuck in the trees, they saw him go in. EWO blinks forward into the aggressive position, but BSJ is going to get clipped by this Ice Blast. They're still going out to this PA. Blinks back with the Thunder God's Wrath there. BSJ is actually being held in place here, but the Fiend's Grip with a big Japanese Blast will send Van back, and the Phantom Assassin has nowhere to run but back. Doomsday AA, I'm sure you've lost. You're dead under your tier 2s, and that's going to be it. Three dead, looking like the fourth smash. Good force step over to the side to save him for now. There's Bane Elemental. Still going to go Scepter out. Radiant's top tower. Five do not die. They lose three, but they'll get the tier 2 here. Yeah, exactly what you're saying. The past few games, like three series I've seen from EnemyGG so far, has been two of the games they've picked BSJ slot and they've lost, just off like the Slark pick. It completely looked like their lanes have done nothing and the Slark has just halted and been aggro tried. The other games though, but like a Terrorblade, Alacrity Shield, they've had Ursa a hell of a lot of the time. If they can group up with BSJ who gets 10-15 minutes of pre-farm, they do exceptionally well. They always play for the early game. I don't think I've ever seen them actually get ready and play for the late game without faltering at the laning stage.
Yeah, that's kind of the name of the game in the meta right now. It's like, you need to find heroes that are able to lane. Like, having strong laners is pivotal, like, to winning right now. And kind of, like, Slark is not a good laner, right? Like, hero, even if you try lane it, it's pretty weak, so it's easy to shut him down. And Ursa is, like, able to lane, and he still scales decently in the late game. Terrorblade, stuff like that. Like, Terrorblade's a better laner, so